What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. It's Typography Tuesday, the series where I bring you guys a graphic design tutorial or video every single Tuesday that's based around typography design. If you want to skip the intro, move to the time card in the corner to jump right into today's tutorial. Now, last week on Typography Tuesdays, I showed you guys my new font that I made myself, Script Satori, and also showed you how to use Font Self to actually generate a font file of your own artwork. But today I'm going to show you guys how to make the artwork itself with two different methods in Adobe Illustrator. So follow along and jump into my tutorial today here at Typography Tuesday on how to design your artwork for your very own font in two different methods. This is the first method of creating your very own typography artwork in Adobe Illustrator. It involves the use of a Wacom tablet, or any drawing tablet for that matter. If you don't have a drawing tablet, or you simply don't want to listen to this method, skip to the time card in the corner for the second method in today's tutorial. You'll want to open up the rulers to access the guides, and to do this, press Command or Control R, and then simply drag the guides down to fit your hand lettering typography into. You can adjust the color of your guides as well as them being dots or lines in the Illustrator preferences right here. If you right or control click the artboard, you can lock and hide the guides if you feel that you need to. We are going to be creating a calligraphy brush for our typography artwork, so go ahead and open up the brushes window here. A lot of these settings will be personal preference to you and your hand lettering, but the third and final setting should be set to pressure. So when you press harder on the drawing tablet, the line will become thicker. This is essential for some quality hand lettering typography artwork. Now these settings might take some time to experiment with and to get right. When you are ready, take the tablet pen and start drawing your lettering between the guides. If you feel the settings are not right, go into the brushes window and double click the brush here. You can then adjust the settings and once you're ready, apply them to the current stroke. I will just draw out some more hand lettering to show you how to tidy up the letters after generating them. I forgot to bring down the guide for the ascender, which will represent the higher stretched out letters. Like before, you can right or control click to hide, unlock or lock the guides. Your lettering is now a stroke instead of a vector path, and if we want to edit the lettering fully, we want to outline the stroke, which will enable us to manipulate the vector path. Once you have outlined the stroke, you will probably see overlapping areas on your typography artwork, which needs to be tidied up. Simply access the Pathfinder window and then use the Unite option on each individual letter. Secondly, we can go into the Simplify option here and click Preview to see real-time changes. It's always better to have as little anchor points as possible on your typography whilst keeping the general shape of your lettering. Press A on your keyboard to access the direct selection tool, which would allow you to move anchor points around and stretch out the handles, furthering your manipulation of your typography. People have asked me, how do I get large anchor points? Well, if you have Illustrator CC, you can adjust the size of an anchor point in the preferences, which can be very handy indeed. Lastly, the amazing Smooth tool will be very handy indeed for you to edit your typography. You will need to locate the Smooth tool and then select the lettering with the selection tool and then click back onto the Smooth tool. Carefully smoothen out the lettering or click an anchor point over and over again. take your time to utilize these techniques to make your very own typography artwork in Adobe Illustrator. So that was the first method on how you can design artwork for your very own font using Adobe Illustrator. We're going to be going into the second method now, and also let me know in the comment section below which one of these methods you find more useful and which one do you think you'd use to make your own font. And also, of course, if you're enjoying today's tutorial, drop a like and also subscribe if you haven't done already to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. The second method of making your very own typographic artwork uses a pen tool. I'm going to show you how to create fluid and professional typography using the pen tool. To begin, you might want to maybe draw out your typography onto a sheet of paper, then scan or snap a picture and upload it to Illustrator as a template to draw around. For the purposes of today's video, let's say this letter on screen here is actually something I created and mocked up onto paper and uploaded it to Illustrator. You can of course use the image trace function, but I feel it's very useful to know how to use the pen tool in a professional way to make typography. Here, I have a calligraphy style letter locked down as a template to draw around. You can press Ctrl or Command R to open up the rulers. And then we need to use vertical and horizontal guides to place just where the letter touches. When we use the pen tool, we can use the tricks and techniques that we've just covered at 90 degrees angles, but never use 45 degree for typography. I will show you what I mean now. So carefully place your guides just touching the letter at 90 degree angles. With the pen tool, click, but with Alt and Shift held down, and then drag out a handle in the direction that you want to head. Never bring the handle past the opposing guide. So on this point here, I will not move it past the guide on the right. You now have a curved line to which you can move to the next point. Hold down Shift and make a click and drag to make the handles, keeping things at 90 degrees angles the entire time. We can use Alt to adjust the handle curves, taking our time to be precise with everything. Shift will help keep things level also. From the new point, repeat the process of holding down Alt and Shift together and then drag out a handle, and then make the new point. If you carry on with this technique carefully, you'll be able to draw out perfectly smooth and crisp lines using the pen tool in Illustrator. It does take some time to get used to, but this is the most methodical and best way to work with the pen tool when creating lines in Illustrator, especially for typography such as this. Practice this technique and master the pen tool with typography.
So there is today's video on two different ways that you can make your very own artwork for a font design using Adobe Illustrator. I showcased you two different techniques today, but which one did you think was the more useful and a more practical method for making a font using your own artwork? For me personally, I prefer just to get out the Wacom tablet and just freehand draw and then take the tools from Adobe Illustrator to kind of smoothen everything out and finalize it. But this is a contrast to how I used to be. I used to actually like to draw my font out on paper. Then, you know, as I showed you, upload it to Illustrator and then use the pen tool to go over it. Now, I do think you need to have mastered the pen tool to actually do that method. And I know we're not all amazing at using the pen tool. I know I certainly wasn't for a very long time. So that's why I showed you two methods today in Satori Graphics Typography Tuesday's video. I'm actually working on my subscription-based website at the moment, where next month I'm going to launch a website that you can pay monthly to for a small fee, or you can actually save money and pay for an annual fee, where there's going to be courses, graphic design vectors, available for download, updated every single month. So if you like my teaching style and the videos I make here, you might want to consider signing up to my courses and my graphic design downloads on a monthly basis, coming hopefully next month. I'm going to be making more in-depth tutorials and more in-depth courses on things such as the pen tool and other aspects of graphic design. I'm going to be back on Thursday with more graphic design content, and also on to Friday, as I usually do here at Satori Graphics, with 4 graphic design uploads. As always, let me know in the comment section below what you think of today's video and my channel in general. I always love reading your comments and trying to improve myself as a content creator and even as a graphic designer. But anyway guys, until next time, design your future today. Peace.